All right, it is 3 o'clock. So we are gonna jump right in and you guys will keep on joining us. But I want to welcome everyone this afternoon to Georgia Public Broadcasting's first statewide webinar. And the screen, you will see in front of you a slide which just gives you some information on how you may wish to join us today on your own devices. So we will be exploring GPB, PBS Learning Media, and Discovery Education, our three sources of content for you. And so if you would like to go ahead and sign in or sign up for your PBS Learning Media accounts, I want to give everyone just a couple minutes to do that, as well as sign in to your Discovery Education accounts. Those are both available to you at no cost. And in fact, they're available, PBS Learning Media and GPB are available throughout the country in case we do have non-Georgia participants today, and Discovery Education also has made their service available to schools throughout the United States. So all of these resources today should be wide open for everyone participating today. Besides the instructions you see in front of you in this slide about how to go ahead and join us on this and the two different streaming services we'll be exploring, you'll probably also see that here in Zoom, we have some unique tools as well, which may be a little new for some of you. So because we cannot see or hear you, our participants, you are muted and invisible. You can interact with us through the Q&A screen. So you should all have a Q&A option, question and answer option, and you may at any time reach out to us with a question and we will respond to that question in real time. And we will probably be responding by writing back to you rather than stopping the webinar and answering verbally. However, if there is a question that really seems to influence the direction we're going in, then we will change that direction. But wanted to let you know, please do engage with us through the Q&A so that we can be here for you and answer your questions, the questions that you have specifically for us. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and move along. And I'm presenting on Nearpod. So this is a Nearpod presentation. We will be sharing this presentation with all participants. So after we say goodbye, at the end of this hour and a half, we will send you an email with a copy of this presentation, as well as a copy of the broadcast. So you can go back and watch it again. And you can also go back and go through the presentation. So you'll have those resources available to you after this webinar. And you will also have that access to us. So you can respond to the email that we send with any questions or anything that we can do to help you. We are here to support you. So keep that in mind. That you will have those resources available. All right, so I'm going to move along here and just welcome you all officially to the Online Educator's Guide to the GPB Galaxy. I'm Tracy Wiley from Georgia Public Broadcasting's Education Outreach Team. I cover the north of Georgia, which is 81 school districts and all the schools within them. And my colleague, Michael Kinlan, who you'll see in a little screen as well, he is our education outreach specialist for South Georgia, and he is in Savannah right now. He covers 181 school districts. So between the two of us, we support all school districts in Georgia and are just here to jump out and let you guys know that we're here to support you. We have all of our content has been free and online since the very beginning. We want to remind you of what's available, but we also want to tweak our presentation today for this unique situation that we find ourselves in. So how to use our content in this situation of our new schooling. So the goals for today are just to help you all become more familiar with GPB's free digital learning resources, specifically in the context of online learning. So we will be going into Georgia Public Broadcasting's, our created resources that we create ourselves in our own studios, as well as the resources created by PBS Learning Media and Discovery Education. So those three different platforms will be covered today. We also want to talk a little bit about not just the content, but how to present this content in meaningful ways, especially for now. And I'm going to go back one because I love this image. I really feel it's appropriate for how we all are kind of feeling right now. We're these in this very unique situation, a little overwhelmed by all by the newness, the changes that are going on so rapidly, and also by all the content that's kind of being shared with us, because all these educational institutions are very supportive and we're getting lots of content. And so I think we're feeling a little overwhelmed. So hopefully today this will help you put some things in context and get more control of the situation and feel more comfortable. All right, so we are going to start with just the agenda. This agenda is also was made available to you beforehand, but I just wanted to go over it really quickly, that from 3 to 3:30, we will be delving into GPB, and you can see some of the links to the resources that we will be exploring during that first half an hour. The second half an hour from 3:30 to 4 o'clock, we will be going into Discovery Education, and here are some highlights of the resources and tools that are available to you through Discovery Education. And then from 4 to 4:30, we will wrap things up with PBS LearningMedia. And again, we have highlighted some of our favorite resources for the core areas that are available to you through PBS LearningMedia. So that agenda will also be available to you with all of the live links within this presentation. This is a graphic that just kind of puts everything in perspective one more time for you. Mike and I are from Georgia Public Broadcasting. We create our own content, but we also sponsor PBS Learning Media, the largest distributor of content in the United States. It is in 98% of households. We are all very familiar and comfortable with PBS. And then Discovery Education, which is the largest distributor of educational content on the planet. And Georgia teachers and students also have open access to Discovery Education, free access to that. So we like to sort of joke, it's like having Netflix, Hulu, and Amazon Prime. You have all three different services. They have different content. So between the three of them, you have about 300,000 pieces of content, and surely you'll find what you need within them. So just keep that in mind. This graphic will lead you to all three of those resources from this one page. We are going to start with GPB Education and the content that we create. And there are three different areas that we'll be highlighting, three different subtopics here. The first one is GPB's Georgia-focused content, so very specific for our needs and interests here in Georgia. The second is some of our complete online classes that are available to you through GPB, because of course we are doing full instruction now, many of us digitally and online, and so we want you to be aware that there are classes that are complete out there with everything you need to complete every standard for that course. And also we want to highlight our virtual and game-based learning resources, because they are just so engaging and are really useful for this time period when we can share them with our kids. So I want to make sure you're aware of those. So first of all, we're going to go into Georgia Public Broadcasting. If you're following along on the Nearpod, you're welcome to click that link, or you could open a separate tab at gpb.org. And you can see this is our website, very simple, gpb.org. If you hover over the Education tab, you'll be able to see some highlights of the content that we create, some quick links here, and some of the content, the resources that are new over here in the middle. And then some of our education partners, the two that we'll be highlighting today, Discovery Education and PBS Learning Media. You'll also see on the right here that we will often change that particular resource depending on timeliness. So right now, we're letting you know that we have a daily newsletter going out with all digital resources and free digital resources available to you, and that will come out every day. You're welcome to sign up for that and receive that in your inbox first thing in the morning, just to help you get started each day with new resources. So we are going to be going through this content for the rest of the presentation. We just want to let you know what's available to you and how to get to it. All right, so moving along, the first thing, Georgia-focused content. So GPB, of course, we create content that is very unique for our students and ourselves here in Georgia. And the first thing that I wanted to point out for you all is fast forward. So for those of you who are not aware of this, this is our STEAM career series. We travel all over the state of Georgia and we interview different people in different careers and jobs that are available to our students in our state. You can navigate through this resource in many different ways. You can see that all of the episodes are available through this tab. teachable moments are when we have taken science, STEAM instruction out of the video and we've isolated them for you, and we'll get a little bit more into that. We have collections, so they're collections around a CTAE or STEAM topic. You can also access the videos by a map. So if you want to see what kind of jobs are available on the beach, you can do that. And then standards, you can search by standards. So if you are trying to find content around a specific Georgia Standard of Excellence, you can look for it that way. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on the collections here so you can see how we have featured our videos around a particular collection. So we have videos around agriculture, the arts, education, engineering, entertainment, food and beverage, and continuing down. So each one of these collections will lead you into a particular field. So why don't we go into health right now, since it says on everyone's mind, healthcare. So if you click on the healthcare collection, then that will pull up different areas where the careers in Georgia, such as the CDC, Policy and Health System, the Georgia Sea Turtle Center, and Augusta University. So these are particular areas that your kids can go in and explore. If I click on CDC, you can see that there is a video all about careers and job opportunities at the Centers for Disease Control. It's about 7 minutes long, so relatively short and engaging video. The STEAM category is science, and there are support materials with each of these videos. So discussion questions, expansion activities, and vocabulary, as well as links to other organizations that may have content that is relevant.
Hey, Tracy. Also,
yes.
Could you tell me the Nearpod code really quickly?
Absolutely. So for those of you who are trying to join the Nearpod, we'd like to be making notes on each slide. That code is IWGQE. And you are welcome to go to nearpod.com, join with this code, and you can make notes in each slide. Thank you, Mike. All right, so back to fast forward here. Sorry, got some different. Give me 1 second to pull that back up. All right, back to the Centers for Disease Control. And you can see on the right here that there are teachable moments. So as I mentioned, these are where they pull content out of the video and just very short bursts on what is epidemiology, and again, on what is mutation and antibiotic resistance. So different videos about those particular areas of interest. And there's also a shorter version of this video on the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, which is about 4 minutes. So a little bit shorter than the 7 minute video. So that's an example of content that you can find that's very Georgia-centric. And you can also, of course, search by keyword. So please do jump in if you have any questions for Mike to answer. And I'm going to move along. And we can pause as needed. The second resource that I wanted to share with you now, we've got about 15 minutes left for GPB, are our live explorations. So Georgia Public Broadcasting, we do travel throughout the state and we feature certain areas that your kids may not be able to go to live. And of course, that's even more the case now as we are traveling, quote unquote, around Georgia virtually. And so we want to share with you some of these places where you can visit through your computers or your individual devices. So you'll see that they are kind of moving across the screen in slides. One of the first places we went was the Okefenokee Swamp. We talked about predator-prey relationships and ecosystems, and again, careers in the Okefenokee. Gray's Reef was also an earlier place that we went, where we talked about a lot about pollution and our stewardship of the environment. And you can see Reduce, Reuse, Recycle just flashed on the screen there as well. That's coming up soon. That is our next live exploration on recycling. We went to Georgia Tech's Flowers Invention Studio to explore the engineering design process and the whole concept of failing forward, entrepreneurship, how do we come up with these great ideas that help us to advance as a society. And so each one of these, going forward, you can click on one of them. So why don't we go into Okefenokee here. And you can see when you click on the Okefenokee Swamp, you will have access to the entire live exploration. It was almost an hour long. You don't have to watch the whole thing, but if you want your children to go and experience the entire experience, they do have access to that archived live exploration. And you can see below as I'm scrolling down that there are teacher resources for every grade band. So we have K through five. These are additional resources to support the live exploration, 6 through 8 and 9 through 12. We also have vocabulary lists for elementary and middle and high school. And then going down, you can see there's more resources below. So that is what our live explorations will look like. And as I mentioned, there are several of them to choose from, depending on your interest and what kind of standards you are working on at the moment. All right. Going to move along from our live explorations and go into our virtual field trips. So we also have virtual field trips. Live explorations are when we go to a location live. Just as they say, we broadcast it by television and computer. And when those are taking place, you can sign in and participate live. You can ask questions in real time and participate in that experience. But we also do virtual field trips throughout the state. And those are where we go to a location and we create an exploration for you. So there may be a CGI map or a timeline or even virtual reality rooms that are available for you to enter into the virtual field trip and begin exploring. And these, of course, can also be accessed at any time. So I'm gonna jump in and show you the first one here, our Georgia Forest virtual field trip. And you can see that there are teacher resources that go with this field trip. So these resources will be lesson plans, expansion activities, STEAM activities around the content. So all kinds of engaging learning resources available for you. There's information about the webinar, about the virtual field trips as well. In this case, we have pulled out 360-degree videos that you can view either on your computers or in Google Chrome or in virtual reality goggles if you have those as well. So when you launch one of these virtual field trips or virtual learning journeys, which are a little bit more in depth, you'll see that it will take you into some choices. So we have Slavery and Freedom, our newest virtual learning journey, this Georgia Forest we just mentioned, and others as well. So when you click on one of them and launch it, then it will take you into the experience. So I am at the moment launching the Owens Thomas House Slavery and Freedom virtual field trip for social studies. I'm gonna skip the beginning. And you can see that this one, the way that you access it from your computer, and again, there are different ways to access it. You can access it from our app. We have a free app. We also have it in Oculus Go if you have Oculus goggles. But from the computer, this is how you would access the experience. It is from an overhead map. And so each one of these locations you can enter into and explore. So if we want to go into the garden, for instance, you click on that site and it takes you into a 360-degree video of the gardens outside the house. Any of these areas will take you deeper into the virtual learning journey. So you'll also see these blueprints of buildings that you can access. And each one of these has ways that you can tour it, you can explore it. And when you enter into a particular room, you'll have more information into the room. So I'm going to enter into this room here. And you can see it is a 360-degree or a view of the room with hotspots that are embedded, and each of these hotspots will tell you more about the experience of the room, about the different artifacts and highlights. And then there's a summary of the room of what you are looking at, and there are also some activities that you can do as well. So this is a writing activity, an informational constructed writing response. So this is an example of what one of our virtual learning journeys will look like. As I mentioned, there are many of them. You can find them here under our virtual field trips tab, and you can see that we have the Owens Thomas House that we just saw a quick glimpse of. We have Georgia Forest, the Civil Rights Movement virtual learning journey, We go to three different Indian mounds, Akmulgee, Kolomoki, and Etowah. Little White House and Warm Springs, Georgia, the second home of Franklin Delano Roosevelt. We have the University of Georgia, Andersonville Prison in, of course, the context of the Civil War, the Creek and Cherokee Nations, including an exploration of New Ashoka, the regions of Georgia, so all five physiographic regions are featured in that virtual field trip. The physical features of Georgia, there are 12 separate virtual field trips within that one, to 12 different physical features. And entrepreneurship, we talk about these entrepreneurial organizations and entities that began in Georgia. So Aflac and Coca-Cola, Georgia Pacific and Delta, Home Depot are featured there. And then Jimmy Carter as well, the life and achievements of Jimmy Carter, our Georgia president. So that is a summary of our Georgia content in terms of the video series that we have available for you, the live explorations, as well as some of the virtual field trips.
Hey, Tracy?
Yes.
Mobile availability?
Yes, so I mentioned, and Mike, if let me know if this is what you mean, but we have a free app, the GPB VR and AR app. You can access that through any device. So it can be an Apple device or a Android device, a phone or a tablet. So you can download that free app onto your device, and then that will give you a virtual 360 degree experience through most of these resources. I'm gonna go ahead actually and show you at gpb.org/VR. That there is a page that has all of our virtual reality content here. So all of our videos, and then you can see also the Civil Rights Movement, Slavery and Freedom, Atlanta Symphony Orchestra. So there's quite a few. We've also partnered with Georgia College, and they have very kindly added their virtual reality tours to this page. So you will see our virtual reality as well as Georgia College on this page. So gpb.org/VR will get you there. Also, if you do have access to Oculus Go's, you can download our free content through Oculus Go and Oculus Rift and different Oculus virtual reality goggles as well. Is that good, Mike? All right, excellent.
So just gonna chime in really quick. GPB VR app for all the virtual reality. If you just want all of the virtual field trips, that would be just the GPB Education app. So there are two apps. One does the Georgia Studies digital textbook plus all the virtual field trips, and then there's another one for VR. Both of them are for free, and you can get them both for all different devices, Android or iOS.
Yes, thank you very much. Wonderful. Keep those questions coming, everyone. Thank you for helping steer our time together today. All right, so that was Georgia-centric content. We're going to go into complete online classes. So Georgia GPB offers two science-based online courses. They are complete, one Carnegie unit for high school chemistry and for high school physics. So we're going to go into Chemistry Matters first. And the way that this video series works is that there are seven units. So the videos are divided into units, and I'm sorry, 12 units, there's seven of physics. So 12 chemistry units, and each unit is broken down into segments. And within each segment are going to be video explorations, labs, and teaching materials. So we'll go into, let's go into chemical reactions, unit 5. You can see that there are five different segments. If we go into the first one, segment A, balancing equations, you'll see that there is a video here, about 15 minutes long. This is a video of students in a model classroom modeling a lab experiment. So you can either share this with your students, you can share it out, or you can watch it yourself and get some ideas for how you might want to do a live webinar or a recorded webinar yourselves about how to do this lab or a lab at home. You can also see that there's a toolkit that comes with each video segment. So this particular one has a PDF on measuring chemical reactions as well as note-taking guides and segment questions. There are closer look videos. So if you have kids who need a little bit more extra instruction, There's a short video on balancing equations. And it also talks about the cross-cutting concepts in science and engineering practices that are covered in this particular segment. You'll see on the right here that there's vocabulary, a little index there for you, for your students to learn about some of the vocabulary that's used. These are the Georgia Standards of Excellence that are covered in this particular segment. And of course, for teachers out there, the teacher content is locked. It is not available to students. So if you would like to have a copy of the teacher toolkit, then you can just reach out to us and we will make that available to you. But it is not available to our students. So that is an example of what a particular segment might look like. You'll also see up here at the top, there's a series toolkit. And if you click on the series toolkit, you'll see that there are some other resources available to you, scope and sequence document, several periodic tables. And one that I feel, two that I feel are specifically, are very, very useful here, are the standard alignments for chemistry and physical science. So if you look at that one, this series was designed for high school chemistry. However, many of the segments are aligned as well to high school physical standards and, I'm sorry, high school physical science and middle school physical science. So as you scroll down, you'll see, for instance, segment C on physical properties and phase change. That segment addresses these standards of high school chemistry, but it also addresses these standards of high school physical science and these standards of middle school physical science. So this is a resource which is useful for both middle school and high school teachers. Right, moving along. Physics in Motion, very similar to our chemistry matter series. It is the same arrangement. And so in this case, we have 7 units that are broken down into segments. And when you go into a particular unit, let's go into describing motion, distance, and displacement. You will see there is a video here as well. This one is 5 minutes and 52 seconds. A little bit different than Chemistry Matters because we have 4 hosts in this series. 2 of them are in the studio guiding the exploration, and 2 of them are out in Georgia finding real life examples of physics. And so here we are at a playground. And you can see the kids can see how physics applies in real life and maybe see some recognizable places throughout our state. So it's a little bit different in the way that it's presented. But you can see below, we still have learning objectives and toolkits available for you. So note-taking guide, questions to consider, practice problems, and a lab. And then here are those vocabulary words, the Georgia Standards of Excellence alignments, and again, how to request the teacher toolkit. And going back to the top, there is your series toolkit again, just like the one in Chemistry Matters. And when you page down to the standards alignments, you will see that this series also is aligned to high school physics, as well as high school physical science and middle school physical science. You can see the alignments across the board. So hopefully these are some resources that will help you as you're looking for complete courses in the sciences. So everything you need is available, the video instruction, as well as all the supportive materials. The other course that we want to share with you, many of our Georgia Studies teachers are aware of this, but want to share with you that we have a Georgia Studies collection. So this covers everything needed for 8th grade social studies. We have a student textbook, a teacher textbook, which is locked, so you do have to apply for access to that. It is still no cost, but you do have to reach out to us and ask for access so we can provide you with a username and password to that to protect that content and the assessments within it. There are those 34 virtual field trips that we mentioned earlier. They are also collected here in the Georgia Studies collection. Even though they're not all completely Georgia, of course, the civil rights movement is for nationwide, and many of the virtual field trips apply for US history as well. And then we have our Georgia Race Through Time interactive games. There's some game-based learning we'll talk about in a little bit. And we have our Georgia Stories series, our oldies but goodies. They've been around for a while, and you'll be happy to know that we are updating many of them. So if you're not already aware of that, we have about 4 videos that have been updated. Here they are, the animated version. And so those are very, very recent. And the particular ones they're showing now are the Georgia Constitution, as well as our legislative, executive, and judicial branches of government, state government. All right, so I'm gonna go back to our Nearpod. And move to the next slide. So we have covered Georgia-centric content as well as our complete courses. We are almost out of time for the GPB section of this webinar. So I'm going to quickly go through the last slides. And again, you can access this at your own time at home when we send you this presentation. But wanted to highlight some of our virtual and game-based learning resources. The Georgia Race Through Time, as I mentioned, is part of our Georgia Studies collection. It is an adventure game with our young teenager Savannah and her dog Peaches. And they are traveling around the state trying to find 24 hidden primary sources. And if they find them before the bad guys, the adults with power and money, then they can win the race. And you can see all of Georgia is featured. Your students need to understand latitude and longitude, the cardinal directions, the physiographic features, physiographic regions of Georgia and physical features. They will be given geographic and history clues to try to find their way around the state. And once they get to where they're going, they have to play a game which tests their soft skills, and such as comparing and contrasting, opinion versus fact, sequencing, things that they need to know to succeed, but they get to do it in the context of this game of Georgia history. All right, the next game I want to highlight is our Lights, Camera, Budget game. This is our most recent game, very exciting. We did this in partnership with the Georgia Council on Economic Education. And this is an exploration of the film industry in Georgia. So your students can go in and make their own movie. But in order for their movie to succeed, they must understand financial literacy. So they'll be tested throughout for their financial literacy skills. And depending on how well they do, that influences the success of their movie. So they may have a 1-star movie or they may have a 5-star movie. And of course, they can play it over and over again until their movie is a great success. But this is a wonderful, engaging game that works really well for our Georgia film industry while teaching our kids things about like budget and investing and making good monetary decisions. And then the last thing we wanted to highlight for you in this section is Gasha Go. This is for our littles, grades K through 3. This is a numeracy game. And again, these are all wide open. They're just at gpb.org. You can click on them and you send your kids right in to play with them. The Gasha Go is set in an arcade after hours, and all the little toys come alive and they need our help, our students' help to restock the games with toys. And so the students have to answer questions and test their numeracy skills in order to help the little creatures refill the games. So that's a very fun and colorful game as well. All right, and we have finished the three parts of GPB, Georgia-focused content, complete online classes, virtual and game-based learning. Mike, was there anything you wanted to add or any questions that popped up to wrap up that section? All right, so remember, we are going to be compiling all the questions from this webinar, and we will also send those to you, the questions and their answers, so that you can, again, revisit if you'd like to go back into the webinar and rewatch it, or look at our presentation outline, or look back at the questions and answers at your own time. So now we're moving very quickly through the content. All right. Just going to pause right here and give you guys a chance to ask some questions, but it looks like we're doing it as we go along. So I'm going to keep on moving into discovery education. Now, we are just going to be covering about 30 minutes of discovery education today. It is a very rich resource. Usually when Mike and I provide trainings on this resource, we prefer to have 2 to 3 hours. So it is so much to see. But we are hosting an additional webinar on Friday at 3:00. Discovery Education, our partners, are going to be hosting that webinar. And that will be from 3:00 until 4:00 on Friday. So if you just get your feet wet during this next 30 minutes and would like to see more, please join us again for that open free webinar on Friday. And I will show you how to register for that at the end. All right, so the first thing I wanted to say about Discovery Education is that normally this resource is not it is a locked resource. So in order to get into it, you do have to have a special code or have special access. So for those of you who are not familiar with how to get into your accounts, I wanted to just give you some information up front and let you know that if you still have trouble with accessing Discovery Education after this webinar, please do respond to our email when we're sharing you the webinar outline. Just respond to Mike and I, and we will help you get into your free accounts and help you get your students set up. So keep that in mind, that this is not the end, that we are here all the time and are very, very happy to help you work through this process. But just wanted to highlight that about a third of Georgia schools have access to Discovery Education through their learning management system. So they have set up single sign-on, and through that platform, the teachers and students are simply able to click on the icon or the thumbnail that is available through your platform and automatically be sent to their accounts. So there is no username or password required. And just quickly going through this list, I will scroll down, but you can see we've got Atlanta, Barrow, Bartow, Ben Hill, Berrien, Bibb, Bullock, Calvary Day School, Carrollton, Centennial, Chattooga, Cherokee Children's School, Clark, Cobb, Colquitt, Columbia, Cook, and I don't think I'm gonna read them all because it does sound a little silly. So I'm gonna keep on scrolling slowly so you can see we're at Gordon now, Green Hall, Henry. If you do not see your school system or your individual school on this list, it means that you do not have single sign-on access and you will have to get into Discovery Education manually just through discoveryeducation.com. So scrolling back up. So if you do see your school system, you can access them through Google, ClassLink, Schoology, whatever here in this column it says. So for instance, Glenn has Google, Forsyth has ClassLink. We've got Canvas for Cherokee, Clever for Ben Hill. So keep in mind, if you're not aware of that you can go through your technology to access Discovery Ed. If you are not on that list, then you need to go to discoveryeducation.com and create your own account. Now, if you do not have an account, again, reach out to us. We will provide you with the code that is needed. If you do know your username and password, you can just log in here at Discovery Education and it will take you to your homepage. So that's just a brief introduction to how to get into Discovery Education. Again, we're happy to help you move forward with that after the webinar. So for the next 30 minutes, we are going to be focusing on three different aspects of Discovery Education. One, the robust multimodal content that you have access to. Number two, the differentiated learning strategies that are provided. And three, personalized student engagement, how to access your student accounts. So first of all, robust multimodal content. So going back into Discovery Education, if you already have that open on your screen, you're welcome to just follow me down the rabbit hole here. So at Discovery Education, you will see on your front page, it looks something like this. Now, the really cool thing about Discovery Ed this school year is that everyone has their own launch page. So your page will not look like mine. You probably do not have volcanoes and apples as your first channel. A channel is a collection of content that's interesting to you. But everyone will have these tools across the top. So the first three tools are how to discover content, content that's trending, content by subject, content by standard. The next three tools are how to teach using this content, so how to curate what you need so that you can present it readily, how to build studio boards and embed the content into the studio boards that you can exchange with your students, how to create assessments. These are multiple choice assessments that you can share out with your students. They are automatically graded and sent back to you. Classrooms, how to interact with your students via classrooms. And then on the right here, instructional strategies, professional learning, so more resources to support you. And then this educator network, how you can be in contact with other teachers who use Discovery Education and share your teaching strategies with each other. Very supportive community. So those are the tools you all have access to. And as I mentioned below, these are the channels. You can pick and choose whichever channels you like. So if you decide you don't want volcanoes, you can click on that channel. It'll open up all the content about volcanoes that are available. So we have K through 5 content, 6 through 8 content, and 9 through 12 content. You can see the top row is Kickstart Learning in your classroom. So little mini lesson plans, lesson starters, as well as teaching strategies. Down below, we'll see the favorites, Discovery Education, their top resources about volcanoes. some video segments and some full videos and some images and even more, sound effects and encyclopedia articles. So these are highlighted resources about volcanoes. They are definitely not the only resources about volcanoes, but it is those that are highlighted. Now, if you decide you do not want to subscribe to a channel, if I decide I'm done with volcanoes, I will pull it back up next year when I get to that unit. I go to this little unsubscribe channel or unsubscribe tool here and click on it. And now volcanoes has been removed from my channels. So when I go back up to the left here and click on my home button, you'll see that volcanoes is no longer there. Now apples is my first channel. I can also drag and drop things. So if I decide I want instructional inspiration to be first, I can move it over here to my first slot and move things around as I like. And if I am looking for a particular topic, so for instance, viruses, I can do a search on viruses and I find a channel called Viruses and Outbreaks. So I can click on that channel, see what's available to me through this channel. And if it looks like it is relevant to me, some studio boards, some activities, some images, some videos, then over here at the top, I can subscribe to it. So I will click on the subscribe button and now it's been added to my homepage. When I go home, it will be at the bottom and I can drag and drop it wherever I like. So I can put it back at the top. So that is how you can organize your channels that you all see. But of course, there are different ways to find content as well. You can look at what is trending. So currently what is trending? This, of course, changes on a daily basis. We have the coronavirus, St. Patrick's Day, and the election, some of the top ones. If I want to pull up my trending channel or my channels again, I can go to the waffle in the right-hand corner. This time, I'm going to look by subject. So if I click on the by subject, it'll pull up another way for me to look for content by different subject areas. And if I decide I want more information on science, I can click science. And it'll open up even more science channels. I can do earth science or physical science or science and technology. And I can just keep going deeper and deeper into the content by subject. And then the third way I can search for content is, again, going back to my waffle, I can do by standard. And I can search by the different standards of excellence. So in this case, if we wanted to do let's do the 2015 Standards of Excellence that came out in 2015 on ELA and math. If I click on that, I can change to ELA or math, change my grade band, and then each one of these, I can expand and find different resources that are linked to a specific area of content. So in this particular one, Conventions of Standard English, explain the functions of nouns, pronouns, verbs, and adjectives. If I click on that, it will pull up 139 results that will help me teach to that particular standard. So that's an idea of how to find the content. You can also, of course, use a keyword search. So if I go up to the keyword search box button here, click on my magnifying glass with no keyword, I get 190,558 results. So we have quite a lot of content available through Discovery Education, almost 200,000 pieces of content. And those things run from channels, as we just went through earlier, to videos. You can see that there are 105,000 videos, which means you have 85,000 things that aren't videos, but lots of videos. Images, and those images you can narrow down by clip art, by primary source. Across the top, text here. So the texts are going to include the entire encyclopedia, as well as many different reading passages and activities. Any reading passage, if you click on it and click on a particular reading passage, such as animal adaptations, it will pull you into a doc reader that will change all of your text to speech if needed. So if your kids are going into this reading passage, if you assign this link to them so that they can access the particular reading passage, they have these tools available to them that they can use to see it. So if I'm looking at the first page here, I will have a reading ruler that will help me read. Looks like it's not popping up here. That's probably my home Wi-Fi. There we go. All right, so we have our reading ruler here that will help us help your students, you know, isolate each line as they're reading. but it can also read it to them. So if I click listen, it brings up the text.
How do species deal with changes in their environment? They evolve by developing adaptations that help them live in a particular environment.
Now that is currently reading at the medium level, but you can also, through these tools here, you can adjust the speed to slower or faster. So however you would like to organize that. So that is a great resource. We're talking about multimodal content. So that is one thing very useful for students as they're exploring. All right, let me head back out of that. Get back to, we're gonna go to boards. I'm sorry, to under more here. Let me just reboot. Looks like I've over-filtered. So I'm gonna go into more here, and under more, you can see there's audio files. So that includes songs. There are 3,000 songs, quite campy. They're great. Sound effects, podcasts, and audiobooks. So just highlighting audiobooks, over 1,000 audiobooks, Goosebumps, just some a wonderful array of audiobooks available to you for all different ages. There's The Hunger Games and Clifford's Birthday Party, so pretty much runs the gamut. And then also under more, one of my favorite tabs is interactives. So when you pull up, again, all your content and go under interactives here, you will find that there are about 369 interactives. And this is a great thing to sign your kids to, just some fun games to explore, you know, how plants grow, life cycles, the atlas, electricity, living versus non-living, solar system. So one-stop shop for many, many games as well. So that is a great summary, hopefully, of what is available to you in terms of multimodal content for discovery education. All right, moving along to the next section is on differentiated learning strategies. So besides all this content, discovery education provides ideas for how to present the content, and these work well in the classroom as well as online. So you can see when you click on the strategies link, and that's available to you in your waffle here under instructional strategies, that green tab, it takes you to this page where you have several different learning skills, again, soft skills. So we know that as our children are learning specific content of science, social studies, math, ELA, that they also have to be learning these soft skills about how do they compare and contrast, how do they research, how do they understand and express point of view, how do they summarize something that they've learned or that they've reviewed, how do they identify key ideas and details. So all these skills are very important as they are learning the content. And so you can combine them. You can go into any of these topics. So let's go into key ideas and details. And you'll see under that topic, you have a collection of different strategies that you can introduce to your children, to your students. So one of the most popular ones is AEIOU. And if you decide you want to explore that particular strategy, you can pull it up. There is a video that tells you how, as a teacher, you can teach this strategy. And under classroom materials, there's a PDF that you can pull up and tells you the skills that the strategy helps to hone, the materials that are needed, the overall idea, the phases of learning, and the steps, and even some extension and modification ideas. So these might be really helpful when you're looking for ways to do this in a digital environment. So there are about 150 different strategies available to you through your Spotlight on Strategies page of Discovery Education. So hopefully you'll get a chance to look through all of those and pick out some that are especially useful for you. And again, I'm just sort of moving down through this to show you what's available. If you scroll down from the main page, you will also see that there are new SOS strategy videos for students. So you can also send these videos to your kids through their Discovery Ed account to tell them how to do the strategy and then assign them the strategy with these graphic organizers or however you decide to do it through your digital instruction. So again, lots of resources for you, teacher videos on the end strategies, student videos, graphic organizers. Here they are, top 10 lists. This is a great one. Top 10 for strategies for helping with math instruction, for helping with primary instruction, digital citizenship, all these different skills. So you can go into any of these and pick out the top 10 strategies and maybe start with there. All right. So I hope that is a useful area for you. I do want to go back home, click on the left home button, and point out to you that these strategies have also been paired with studio boards under the channel Instructional Inspiration. So for those of you who are able to access your Discovery Education account right now, you'll probably see that you all have this channel. It's one that is given to everyone when they first sign up. And if you click on it, it will take you into the page with a collection of boards, digital boards that have been made for you with the strategies embedded in them. So you can see, for instance, let's go to 9 through 12 here, jump on up to high school. And you'll see under 9 through 12, ELA, this first one, evaluating a source, 1865 reward poster. And the strategy featured is AEIOU. So I'm going to click on that. And this is a digital board that has been created by Discovery Education that you can use in your own instruction. So the board here talks about the directions. Carefully read this poster. Here we've got some great primary source analysis going on. And respond to the different prompts. So we've got the poster here, the primary source. And below, it's asking you to do the strategy AEIOU. So think of an adjective that describes the media. Write your answer here. Think of an emotion. How do the media make you feel as we are, you know, investigating history? We're not just automatons. How does this information make you feel? Put your emotion there, or a sentence with your emotion. The I is what is interesting. What was interesting to you? Something maybe you didn't know about, or something that changed your perspective. What did you get from the media? And O is like something that made you think, oh, that's amazing, or oh, that's horrible, or oh, that's gross. Just anything that kind of had that emotional context within it from the media. And then the last one is like a question that you have from the media or further research you would like to do. So even though it's kind of a simple strategy, AEIOU, your kids can get into a lot of depth exploring their emotions and their interests and, you know, where they may be lacking in terms of their knowledge, how they want to expand their knowledge. Now, up in the upper right-hand corner here, it says create a copy. So you can create a copy of this board, which will go into your studio. And then with your copy, you can change the color or the font or the wording or the video, anything that you want to do. And you can also assign it out to your students, either one student or an entire class of students or a group of students, and they in turn can write directly on the board and send it back to you. So it's a wonderful way in this digital environment for you to create an entire assignment with a rubric, with very clear instructions, with the content embedded into it, share it out to your kids and have them respond to it and give it back to you. So it's a wonderful tool for interacting in this digital learning setting that we find ourselves in. All right, so moving along, we're going to go to the next section in the Discovery Education. We've got about 8 minutes left for this section, and this is on personalized student engagement. So how do your students have access to all this great content? Because they also have no cost resource. They also have accounts here with Georgia Public Broadcasting Discovery Education. So we're going to go into this link, and again, all these links will be made available to you through Nearpod. So I'm going to click on this, and this will take you to just the student experience page. This just gives you some information on how to get started with your students, some of the resources available to them, how to manage your students, assign content, and deal with these resources. Now, if you have single sign-on access, if you're one of those one-third of Georgia that already has single sign-on access, then your students are probably already in the system, and they can go ahead and access their account the same way that you do through their learning management system, through their dashboard. So you will not have to worry about adding your students. If you do not have single sign-on access, then you'll have to add them manually, either through a CSV upload, if you upload the roles, or one by one. That CSV upload can be done at the district level, at the school level, at the class level. So there are different ways to work through this and get your students on board. But I would highly recommend single sign-on if that is a free service that Discovery Ed offers. So would definitely recommend that. You just have to get your learning management system talking to Discovery Education. So if you have Google, but Google has not made that connection with Discovery Education, it won't work. You have to make sure that Google and Discovery Ed have the single sign-on setup created. All right, so I wanted to make sure that was available to you. So if you did want to explore ways to get your students involved, you can. And then I want to show you what it looks like for your students. So this is the My Classrooms tab. So in your waffle up here, if you click on Classrooms, the last purple one, it'll take you to this page here. And you can see that if I click on Students on the left, it'll show me all the students that are in my current classes. And these, of course, are famous Georgians. They're not my real students. But I can see the names of my students, their usernames, and then their actions. I can edit their account. I can log in as them. I wanted to go ahead and log in as a student so you can see what your students have access to. So let's do Hulk Hogan today. I'm going to log in as Hulk. And so now you can see this is what a student account looks like. So all teachers have free accounts to Discovery Education in Georgia. All students do as well. So the student account, you'll see right across the top, they have their assignments right at the top with the due dates and whether or not they've started. So that will jump right out at them. They also have this assignments tab as well. So there are two different ways to see their assignments. And then at the top here, you'll see that they have a magnifying glass just like you do. So remember, when we hit the magnifying glass as teachers, we had 190,000 results. As a student, I have 164,000 results. So a lot of content. Remember, this content is educationally appropriate. It is standards aligned. It is not like sending your students out into Google, which is a wonderful resource, but you just don't know what you're gonna get. If you set them free in Discovery Education, they're gonna find educational content that is appropriate. You are also able to block certain grade bands. So if you decide you don't want your littles seeing grades 9 through 12, content for grades 9 through 12, your administrators can go in and cut off the content at a certain grade level. So you can even limit it for just K-5 or K-2, however you want to do that. You can also block specific pieces of content. So if there's a video that you don't want your students having access to, you can block that content. So there's lots of flexibility there. But here I am, I'm a student. I have access to all this content. I have my own folders, so I can, if I like spiders, I can make folders about all the different spiders. If I like the solar system, because students have different interests, we don't want them all sharing the same account. We want them to have their own account so they can explore their own interests. So if I like the solar system, I can go in and do research on that and make my own folders. One can be called, you know, the sun and the earth and Mercury, and you can just create folders with all the content you want. You'll also see that your students have access to Studio, so they can build their own boards. They can share those boards with you, or they can just build their own boards for fun and embed any content they want into their board. So there's a lot of autonomy here, which is really exciting for this particular circumstances we find ourselves in, to give your kids access to that content themselves. All right, we are running out of time for this section, so I'm gonna move along, and please do keep those questions coming. I'm sorry if we're going so quickly, but I did wanna highlight a couple of examples of student-made studio boards for you, just so you can see what the students can do when they have access to their accounts as well. This first one I'm showing you is actually was made by a teacher. It's an example of the type of assignment that you can make on studio board to give to your students. So this is called Innate and Learned Behaviors. There's an overview, a table of contents. It talks about the standard that it meets. And as you page forward, you can have 5 pages on a studio board. The first page here, we've got this video segment, this image, and it says some background here on innate behavior. And then it has this strategy called 3 truths and a lie. This is one of those many teaching strategies. It says, watch the video and pick out which of these statements is not true. So you gotta pay attention to the video. One of them is in there to trick you. And you can see another video with 3 truths and a lie here. And here's that adaptations that we saw embedded. So that PDF is embedded into this board. And each page of the board goes into more information. So here's learned behavior. And this particular one is a 6-word story. So it's another strategy embedded into this page that is paired with this video segment and this image. And it gives your students an access to another, some more content, and assignment, engaging assignment around that content. So pick one of the videos, it gives them that choice. So again, that wonderful autonomy, pick one of the videos and create 3 6-word stories about that video. And then on the last page, we've got a skill builder, how to identify and understand text features. So we've got some reading passages, videos as well, and then the assignment down here. So that's an example of what you can do with a board, how you can share it out to your students. And then example of what your students can do. So this particular one was created by a student, art by Evelyn. So here she is just sharing her art projects from the year and has embedded each one of them into this board. So you can see, so everyone can see what she's worked on this year. Go ahead and close that one out. And then the next board, this was a collaborative board because your students can work together on a board. They are collaborative, and this board was made by Leilani, Kiamaya, Kevin, and Jakiri. And they made this book on this. This is a screenplay. They're going to do a play from the Diary of Anne Frank. So they created their own setting, summary of the acts, and they have an explanation of the characters and the script. So they put this together as a group so they can share it with their, in this case, digitally, so they can, so you can see what kind of script they've come up with. So again, some great content that is available for your kids to create on their own and share back with you. All right, so that is the end. It's right on time, 4 o'clock. Discovery Education Resources, we talked about the multimodal content that is available to you through Discovery Education, about 200,000 pieces of content, everything from text to games and podcasts to sound effects, so hopefully a wide variety of content to help you in your instruction. We talked about differentiated learning strategies, how to take that content and share it with your students in a meaningful way, in ways that will help them with their soft skills, their literacy and learning skills, and ways that they can be shared, personalized and shared with your students through their own accounts, and how your students themselves can be doing their own explorations, creating their own boards as well. All right, looks like we have 4 questions. So Mike is getting to those and helping with them. And Mike, jump in if you need to redirect where we're going here, but otherwise we're gonna move along and head into the next section, which is PBS Learning Media. All right, now this is more of an intuitive resource, so we may not need as much time in this one. We may end a little bit early at this one and go into some Q&A at the end. But PBS Learning Media, another wonderful resource. And I just wanna show you how to get into this one as well. So when you pull up your PBS Learning Media account, just go to pbslearningmedia.org. You can either sign in or sign up. You do not need a special code. This one is not closed. So you can sign up with Facebook or Google or any email account. And once you sign in, I'll use my email here just to show you how it works. Once you sign into your account, then you'll see your name up here at the top, and that will give you access to your dashboard. So everyone has a dashboard that they can explore. But just looking at PBS Learning Media, you can see, like Discovery Education, you can browse by subject, you can browse by grade, and you can browse by standard, just like we did before, and there are student accounts as well. So it's very similar, but much more easily accessed. All right, I'm going to move into the 3 different areas we're going to explore for PBS Learning Media. Trusted, recognized content. We're very familiar with our PBS content, and many of us grew up with Sesame Street, and it's been with us around as long as we have. Classroom-ready resources, so things are already ready to go that you can just send out to your kids, and they are open. They do not require any login, so it's not like Discovery Ed where you have to set up accounts. They are open and accessible. And then versatile teacher tools available through your dashboard. All right, so first of all, trusted recognized content. So looking here, you can see if you scroll down from the PBS homepage, they have pulled out content every day that feels especially relevant. So you can see we've got everything from Jackie Robinson to The Handmaid's Tale to high-tech fashion. And moving along, keeping up with news and events. And at the bottom here, you'll see some of what I mean when I say that recognized trusted content. So Arthur, many of us grew up with Arthur. Xavier Riddle is a brand new series that's on PBS right now. And so your kids may be watching that right now. And as you scroll along, you'll see more PBS Kids. For those of us who are older, The Great American Read, we are aware of that, or Crash Course, or Nova, or Nature, or Frontline. So there's content across the board So, oh, excuse me about that. Looks like I went to the wrong tab. So there's content across the board, whether it is Daniel Tiger or Ken Burns. This is content that's recognizable. Now, when you go into this content, go into Arthur, for instance, not only do we have, you know, videos about Arthur, but we have all of these lesson plans. So your children are already familiar with Arthur. They already have a relationship with him and his pals. And so they have that connection, which makes it more engaging right off the bat. So when they see these activities that are available to them, they are more likely to jump in and get involved with them because they are aware, they know these characters. And these characters are available throughout. So you can search by subject here, and you can go into any of the subjects that interest you. So if we go into, let's try K through 8 math this time. So if we go into K through 8 math, you can see all your different subtopics over here on the left. You can filter by grade or by type of content. So whether you want a lesson plan or an audio or a video or a game, an interactive, you can also sort like we did with Discovery Ed to find what you need. You can also sort by standard here. So if you click on that, there are types of standards. We're going to do state standards on the left, and we are in Georgia, and the Georgia Standards of Excellence, and you can sort by your grades. And so you can pull up the standards that you need. So right now we have fourth grade math, and I can go into this particular one, generate a number or shape pattern that follows a given rule. And if I click on that, it pulls up 49 search results that are directly aligned to that particular standard. So different ways that you can search, just like in Discovery Education, as we did earlier. And I also wanted to show you, if you do just click that magnifying glass with nothing in it, it pulls up 32,650 results. So we pulled up 190,000 with Discovery Education. You have an additional 32,000 through PBS LearningMedia. So you can see we're getting up to that 300,000 that I mentioned. When you add GPB as well as some of the content under the surface of Discovery Ed, you get up to about 300,000 pieces of content. So plenty of things to support you. And you can see these are sorted by relevant. So Ken Burns pops it right there, how to take these wonderful Ken Burns documentaries and put them in the classroom with lesson plans and activities. There's Xavier Riddle again. We've got lots of news quizzes going on. So current events, keep up with current events. So hopefully this is also some great content that that you may not have been aware of that's available to you, no charge, at your fingertips. All right, moving along, I did want to mention that we have curated at gpb.org our own collection of our favorites, and these are our favorites from PBS Learning Media as well as GPB. So if you just want a place to start, these are the ones that we love the best: 60 Second Presents, Above the Noise, All About the Holidays, America from Scratch, Braincraft. I just look at these and Crash Course. I watch these for fun. I know I'm a nerdy teacher as well, but these are some really well done, cheeky, fun, engaging content. Girl Power, I love this one. This goes into social and emotional learning as well as just interests. Grow Science is a fun one. I Heart Math, a very cheeky way to teach math. Math Club is another one. See, I would just recommend looking through this, finding some content that jumps out at you. Some Martha Speaks ELA, Molly of Denali, another new series from PBS Kids. So please take advantage of this collection and hopefully use it in your instruction as well. All these have teacher resources with them. All right, and then the second thing with PBS Learning Media, classroom ready resources. So as I mentioned, there are many lesson plans that are already created for you. So I pulled up 262. And what I did to get this particular collection is I just clicked on the search bar here and I didn't search for anything. So let's go back home, click on the search bar, pull up everything. And on the left, I clicked interactive lesson. So it pulled up 262 interactive lessons. Now, of course, you can also search for a keyword and then filter out by interactive lesson on the left. But you can see here that these are all lessons that have been made for you that you can share out with your kids through these links, and then they can go through the lesson. So let's do Meaning of Matter for grades 6 through 8. And I'm gonna launch this lesson. There are support materials that come with it: discussion questions, teaching tips, Here's the standard alignments for it. So we've got Georgia Standards of Excellence here, as well as national standards. You can favorite it if you go through it and decide you really like it, want to keep it in your collection. Or you can assign it or share it with your kids. You can share it via Google Classroom. It is open, so you do not need an agreement between PBS and Google. It just goes straight to your Google Classroom. So I'm going to launch this lesson so you can see what it looks like. Remember, there are about 262 of these. So here's the first page. It gives you some background. There's a video embedded. There's the transcript that goes with the video, tells you what you're going to do, and then it gives you a place to make notes. So you can save that. You can move on to page 2. So each page, there are 10 pages in this particular lesson plan. Here's some vocabulary with video to support the vocabulary. Here's again where you can put your notes. You can see each page is a place for kids to go in and interact with the content and make their own notes and do some assessments. So these lesson plans, I just think, are fabulous. I wish I had these in the classroom. Again, you can share them right out with your kids via a link. Here's a little review, so a little mini assessment in here on page 4. Here's an animation. So you can see it's super rich, this lesson plan. I'm only halfway through it, and there's so much that has been made available. So hopefully you guys are out there looking at this and just going, oh my goodness, this is amazing, because that's my reaction. So again, going back to these interactive lessons, back to this, there are so many of them. So I'm going to pull up again the interactive lesson, filter out, and you can see all the different ones that are available to you. Waves, World War II, Newton's laws, climate. And you can, of course, filter these out by subject, by grade level as well. All right. So the next thing I want to share with you from PBS Learning Media is the teacher tools. So as I mentioned, everyone has a dashboard. So in the upper right-hand corner, once you've logged in, you click on your dashboard, it will take you to this page. And you can see on the left, all of your favorites, everything that you've hearted will be collected here. You have tools, you can make your own lessons, your own quizzes, your own storyboards and puzzles. And they're over here on the right as well. You can assign things to your classes. Here's your class here. So you can set up classes here or interact with your classes through Google. Or through your other learning management systems. You can organize your favorites into folders on the left here. And so you can see it even keeps up with your recent activities. So this is a great place for you to organize what you've been working on with PBS Learning Media. I also just wanna go into my favorites here. I'm gonna click my favorites so you can kind of see what it looks like when you start accumulating favorites. And as I mentioned, you don't need a login to access this content. But it's very useful to have your own account so that you can curate what is meaningful to you. So these are all my favorites that are here, and you can see I put them into folders. So these particular ones are in folders, so I can create folders on the left here, and then I can put my favorite items into the folders by clicking on them. So for instance, here's two about one on how fantasy reflects our world and one about why sci-fi is a mirror on society. So I can click on those and then I can add them to a folder here. If I click add to folder and then I can click something that maybe science. Now I can even make a new one. So there are many ways you can interact with and add it to your folder. You can also delete them, and so you can be constantly curating as well. And then once you've put things into folders, so I'm going to go into my folder called math here on the left. And these are all my favorite math resources that I've collected over the years. And so you can see at the top here, there's a link. And that means I can share my favorite math resources with everybody. So I can make a copy of this link and I can email it to you or share it on social media. And that way you can all have access to my favorite math content. So this is great for media specialists or just sharing with each other when you're homebound, what's some great content you found that you can share with your colleagues. So that is something that is unique to PBS Learning Media, that ability to share your collection openly and freely like that. All right. And the last thing I wanted to show you from PBS Learning Media, you may have seen this on our social media. We are currently sponsoring a PBS Kids Writing Contest. We've extended the deadline. It was going to end at the end of this month, and we've extended it to mid-April. And so we really encourage your children, your students, go into the activity pack to get information on how to enter the contest. We encourage your children to write stories and submit them. And these are the former winners from previous years, and their stories are recorded and then shared with them reading it. So they're really adorable stories. I'm gonna just sort of start this one, My Snow Day. And you can see this is the STEAM winner. So there's a first, second, and third place winner for each grade. And then the STEAM winner as well will come in and have a winner in that category. And so the child will read and narrate their story that they have illustrated. All right, so we are, it's about 4:15. So we're gonna keep going through the presentation because there's some few more things that I wanted to share with you, and then we can open up for Q&A. But I wanted to just review again our session goals. I know we moved very, very quickly through a lot of content. So I do hope that you were able to become a little bit more familiar with the free content that's available to you through GPB, PBS Learning Media, and Discovery Education. We talked about all the different types of content from the Georgia-centric content that GPB produces. And in fact, you can see behind me, this is a landscape from our Georgia Race Through Time game. So this is one of the places that you'll visit if you're playing that game. So we have our own content that we create with that Georgia spin, as well as PBS Learning Media that has that trusted, recognizable content with PBS characters and series that we're all familiar with. And then, of course, Discovery Education with its rich resources, multimodal content, really for every subject area and grade band. So hopefully you became familiar with how to find that content, how to register. And as I mentioned, we will share this with you so that you can email us back with further questions on how to get into your accounts if needed. And then also hopefully there were some ideas and teaching strategies that were shared with you that you were able to learn from the learning strategies from Discovery Education, or some of the resources like the ready-made lesson plans from PBS Learning Media, some of the game-based learning, some of the virtual reality, some of the virtual field trips your children can take. So I hope that this expanded your information about that content and how to present it to your kids. Looks like we have some questions still coming. And while my